Now we will study glomerular filtration. I have divided this topic into three videos. In this video, we will see glomerular filtration rate, filtration fraction, filtration barrier, and filtrability of various solutes. In next video, we will cover determinants of GFR. And in last video, we will go through regulation of GFR and renal blood flow. Glomerular filtration is basically the process of filtration of blood through glomerular capillaries into Bowman's capsule. Glomerular filtration rate, or GFR, is total quantity of filtrate formed in all the nephrons of both the kidneys in given unit of time. Normal GFR is 125 ml per minute or 180 liters per day. That means both the kidneys collectively form 125 ml filtrate in 1 minute or 180 liter filtrate in 1 day. Now filtration fraction. The fraction of renal plasma flow which becomes filtrate is called filtration fraction. So basically it is ratio between GFR and renal plasma flow. Normal GFR is 125 ml per minute and renal plasma flow is 600 ml per minute. So filtration fraction is about 20.8%. So you can remember that around 20% of plasma flowing through the kidney becomes filtrate. Now let's see filtration barrier. As you can see, blood is filtered through this barrier. We have already studied it in detail in video of renal corpuscle. So you know that it is made up of three layers: endothelial cells, basement membrane, and podocytes. The endothelial cells are fenestrated. Basement membrane is also porous, and podocyte layer has filtration slits. It is these gaps through which fluid passes during filtration. Now, although this filtration barrier is highly permeable, it does not allow free passage to all the blood constituents. Filtrability of a particular substance depends on two parameters: its molecular size and electrical charge. Neutral molecules smaller than 4 nanometer in diameter are freely filtered. From 4 to 8 nanometers, filtration is inversely proportional to the size. The larger the molecule, the lesser the filtration. And molecules larger than 8 nanometers are highly restricted. Coming to the electrical charge. Basement membrane as well as podocytes have negative charge on them. They repel negatively charged molecules. So filtration of negatively charged molecules is lesser than neutral or positive molecule of equal size. The filtrability of a substance is expressed as ratio of its concentration in filtrate to that in plasma. Let's take example of sodium ions. As they are very small in size, they are filtered freely. So they achieve same concentration in filtrate as in plasma. So filtrability of sodium ions is 1. Now it is difficult to compare concentration of both the sides if I show all the solute particles separately. So only for ease of comparison, we will assume that particles are settled down. By doing so, we can compare concentration simply by comparing height of the sediment. Here you can see that height of the sediment on both the sides is same, suggesting equal concentration on both the sides. Similarly, other smaller substances like chloride ions, potassium ions, glucose, urea, water molecules, etc. are filtered freely. So their filterability is also 1. Plasma proteins instead are very large in size. Apart from size, negative charge on protein molecules also prevent their filtration as they are repelled by negative charge on basement membrane and podocytes. Consequently, their filtration is negligible. So their concentration in filtrate is very less as compared to plasma. For example, filterability of hemoglobin is 0.03 and of albumin is 0.005. Along with protein molecules, other substances bound to them, such as lipids, are also restricted accordingly. Blood cells, of course, are not filtered because of large size. In short, filtrate is plasma without plasma proteins. Remember, glomerular filtration is a passive process. So no substance achieves more concentration in filtrate than in plasma. So maximum filtrability that any substance can achieve is 1. Well, I guess that's enough for now. We will continue with remaining topics in next videos. See you.